First time you've made any motion all night, and it's in the wrong place. I want to do a song off of our Christmas album. I come from a family of three boys and three girls. And my mom worked at school lunchroom. My dad was a road construction foreman, built roads all over the Southeast. July 30th in 1970, my oldest brother was 13 years old and loved playing in the woods behind our house. And he was out behind the house in the creek shooting crawdads, and an 18-year-old guy came by his way and murdered him. We started singing on Christmas Day following that July 30th. June 5th, 1982, our baby brother reached the age of 13 and decided one Saturday he was going to go fishing right below our house in a little farm pond, him and his best little friend. And before the end of the day, they decided it was so hot they wanted to go in to go swimming. And my baby brother, who was 5'10", drowned in less than 4 feet of water. Then in 2000, my mom had a massive stroke and it totally paralyzed her on the left side. And she had to have 24/7 caregiving. And she passed away 2 years ago, December the 18th, from COVID. My dad, in 2003, had 8 strokes in 8 weeks, and he passed away December the 10th, 2003, at the age of 67 years old. Tracy and I, we had 2 babies that we lost through the 30 years that we were married, and we finally had Jared, which I'm very thankful for. That's probably why he's spoiled rotten, because he's the only child that we had. And then February the 4th, 2018, Tracy passed away. This song was written by Kirk Talley. And I told Kirk, I said, "You must have been hiding behind every tree at my house growing up." I said, "Because every line in this song is my life." We didn't have much growing up except love. You know, Christmas Day around our house was pure chaos with 6 kids and them screaming and yelling and hollering and, you know, jumping and all this stuff. And but we had a good time. And sure. My mom, y'all, was the best cook that I have ever seen in my life. I mean, the woman could throw down some food. And her favorite thing to make at Christmas was homemade, from scratch, coconut cake. And it would be about that high, and it would weigh about 20 pounds. You had to keep it in the refrigerator. And she always put these little plastic fake holly leaves and berries on top. I don't know why, but and she would absolutely dare us to touch that cake before Christmas Day. I remember all of that, and now when I go home, things are so different. Everything's gone. But the love that God showed us and gave us on that little hill that they call Perryville in Dahlonega, Georgia, had some of the sweetest memories. I want you to listen to the songs. Love is alive. Us and ours.
Libby Perry Stone.
Tonight, folks, you may sit here and you may not have that one-on-one personal relationship with Jesus Christ. That's why the Perrys go and we do what we do, for no other reason. I don't want anybody done and going to hell because I failed on my part to tell you about Jesus Christ, His grace and His love and His mercy and His salvation. A lot of people come to church and they say, well, I've went to church all my life. I grew up in church and all that. Well, you can come and warm the seat, but that doesn't make you a Christian. No more than a car sitting in a garage makes it a Christian. Tonight, can I ask you a question? I was telling you about my family and the tragedies and stuff that we've had over the years, and it's just a reminder that none of us are promised the next second. Nobody. If God were to call your number within the next 5 minutes, and it could happen, where would you be at with your relationship? Would you go to heaven? Or would God look at you and say, depart from me, I never knew you? If God was to call me my name in the next 5 minutes, would I be ready to go? Or would I hear those dreaded words, depart from me? So that you can live in peace, joy, and happiness. We
Father, we love you tonight, and we thank you for everything that you've given us. Father, I just ask you right now that if there's someone in here that's carrying a burden tonight, dear Father, that you just reach down and just give them a touch, dear Father. Father, I know that there's people that are hurting, that are lost, that are going through broken marriages and going through sicknesses and different struggles throughout their lives, dear Father. But dear Lord, I ask that they just seek you. Dear Lord, give them that comfort, give them that reassurance to know that if they seek you tonight, dear Father, that you'll be with them even in the valleys. Father, you did that for me, and I know that you can do that again, dear Father. We thank you for everything you've given us. Thank you for all that you've done for us. Thank you for such a wonderful night to just be able to come into your house and just worship to you and just gather together to do it. It's in your Son's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.